Welcome back to my channel, English with Bhavana. So today we will be starting with tenses. I know you all are really confused with the topic tenses. So let's get started with the part one of tenses today. Now, there are three simple form of tenses, the main type of tenses that are simple present tense, simple past tense and simple future tense. What are tenses actually? Ab tenses hota kya hai? Tenses word ka meaning. So, I will say the tenses word meaning is what time. Why time? Because when you're talking about present, okay, that is also time. Future, that is also time. And past, that is also time. So, tenses word is nothing but it refers to time. Okay, now tenses refers to time, that is present, past and future. A verb may refer to present tense, past tense or future tense. Now, example, matlab verb hai. वो कोई भी टेंस को रेफर करेगा एज पर द वर्ब लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल अभी स्टडीज है विद स्टडीज यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट्स प्रेजेंट टेंस हाउ बिकॉज द वर्ब ई एस इज देयर सो इट मीन्स वॉट इट इज अ प्रेजेंट टेंस वर्ब ओके स्टडीड ई डी है मीन्स इट्स पास्ट टेंस ओके विल स्टडी विल इज देयर सो इट इज वॉट फ्यूचर टेंस सो विल स्टडी इन डिटेल टूडे अबाउट सिंपल फॉर्म ऑफ टेंसेस The simple present tense is also called as present simple or present indefinite. It's one of the several form of present tense which is used to show repetition, habit or generalization. The simple present tense is used to talk about general truth of facts as well. Abhi simple present tense kya hota? Sabse pehle aap first point samjho. It is right, for example, every day you have a habit to get up early in the morning. For example, every day I get up at 7 a.m. in the morning. So it is what? It is my habit. Okay? It is repetitively done by me. So it comes under what? Simple present tense. Okay? Repetition, habit or generalization we say. Simple present tense is also used to talk about general truth. General truth of facts. Matlab jo change nahi ho sakta. For example, sun rises in the east. You cannot change it, right? The sun will not rise from the west. So it's general truth. Ye truth hai, jo badal nahi sakta hai. So se hum kis mein lenge? Simple present tense mein. For example, honey is sweet. Shahd hamesha meetha hi rahega. Wo kabhi kadwa nahi hoga, right? So it is general truth. So ye kya hoga? Simple present tense. Now, Speakers occasionally use simple present tense to talk about scheduled events. Scheduled events means aapne already plan kiya hua hai apne events ke bare mein near future ke liye. That time also we say as simple present tense. This is the most commonly done when talking about public transportation, but it can be used with other scheduled event as well. For example, I have a flight tomorrow at 9 a.m. in the morning. So It's scheduled, you know, even though I'm talking about tomorrow, but it's scheduled from today only. So it will not change whether I catch the flight or not. The flight will move as per the scheduled time. So it is what simple present tense. Why? Because it will not change. The timings will not change according to my preference. It is scheduled. And it is scheduled today only. So, though we are talking about tomorrow, though you are telling that tomorrow, ma'am, ye to kal ki baat ho gayi, kal schedule hai, kal aapki flight hai. No, but it is scheduled. We are for tomorrow, near future. That is a near future also. And secondly, this cannot be changed. This cannot be changed according to one's need. So, it is what simple present tense. Now, simple present tense we use in the following cases for habits and routines. For example, your school starts every day at 7 a.m. in the morning. It's a routine. In the third person singular, what you do is you add S or ES. For example, the verb is study. So it will turn to studies when you're talking about simple present tense. Okay? Questions are made with does. Okay? Questions are made with does. And negative forms are made with does not. For example, she does not study. This way we stay, right? Yes. Questions are made with do and negative forms are made with do not. Let's see examples. Ram talks very fast. It's a habit of Ram. Okay? If you see talks, S is there. So just simple present tense. And it's a habit also which comes into simple present tense. We cook every day. Right? We eat every day. We cook every day. It's our routine, which cannot be changed, right? No one else in the world can change it. It's our routine, right? Yes. Do you speak English? So it is again what? Simple present tense. You're forming a question. So we will never change a verb. Whenever you're forming a question, remember the rule which is singular S or ES will not apply because you're forming a question with the help of do over here. Okay, let's see more on it. You do not speak English. Same over here. Whenever you're making it negative also, there are rare cases where the verb changes, verb does not change. Does he speak English? Singular is already does. So you will not change the main verb speaks. You will never say that because you are framing a question. When we are framing a question, we never change verb. Okay, he does not speak English. Okay, let's go further. Now, simple present tense is also used in the following cases: to state facts or truth, to talk about scheduled actions in the near future. Questions are made with do and negative forms are made with do not, which we have already learned it, but I am just repeating for your better understanding. The action can be a habit. It can be a hobby also. It can be a daily event, a scheduled event as well, or something that often happens. Okay. It can be something a person often forgets or usually does not do. Example, the train leaves every morning at 8 a.m. It's already scheduled. It will not leave early or later, whether you reach or not. It's already scheduled. When does the cafe reopen? Now, for example, you know that every day the shop near in your area opens at 9 a.m. But one day you forget. So normally you ask not the other people, the nearby shopkeepers, when does the shop reopen? So it means what? It's an everyday routine actually. So that's the reason we are saying, when does the coffee shop reopen? The sun rises in the east and sets in the west. It's a fact which we cannot change. So as I said, your facts comes under simple present tense. Every 12 months, the earth circles the earth. Again, it's a fact. So, Prachi eats an orange. Prachi is a subject. Eats is a verb. And orange is a object. Now, always remember, children, the sentence is having a subject, object and verb. Okay? So, what is subject in the sentence? First of all, what is a subject? Subject is nothing, but subject is a doer of the action. Subject is a first person, second person, third person. Subject is a noun or a pronoun. Now let's talk about subject over here. Who is doing an action? Who eats an orange? Prachi, right? So Prachi is a subject. Eats. What is the action going on? Eating ka. So it is what? Again, it is action. What does Prachi eat every time? An orange. So orange is what? Object. So subject is the doer of the action. Object is the receiver of the action. Okay. Yes. Now, the basic rule says that simple present tense verb plus S or ES. If the verb is study, you will add ES. Okay. She studies every day for 2 hours. Write. She writes neatly in a notebook. Play. She plays in the garden every evening. So I hope you have understood simple present tense. Now simple present tense, I repeat again, we use it for our habits, routines, for our scheduled events which cannot be changed. Okay, so always remember, simple present tense is also used as a verb we added S or ES. Okay, let's move further to the next type of tense. Now simple past tense. Simple past tense is what? The action is completed. Now, whatever you were doing before this, watching my video. So, that is now completed action. For example, you completed with your work. You completed with your homework. You completed with your playing. Or you were studying. You studied. You ate. So, this all is what? Simple past tense. Because action is completed. And right now, you're looking at my video. You're learning from me tenses. So whatever you were doing before this is known as simple past tense. The simple past tense is also called as past simple, past indefinite. We can say anything, okay? It's a verb tense which is used to show that a completed action took place at a specific time in the past. Now, action duration is not important. Like for example, Before this class, I went for the shopping. So how long I was shopping, that is not important. I completed my shopping. The action is completed. That is important. Okay? Yes. The simple past tense is a verb tense that is used to talk about things that happened or existed before now. One and the same thing. As I said to you, I completed with my verb. I completed my homework. So you never ever say redded, cutted. This is wrong. Okay? So normally we use this only because these are known as irregular verbs. For other irregular verbs, including the verb to be, the simple past forms are more erratic. Example, see, saw. It will not turn to seed. It will turn to saw. Build, built. Go, went. Do, did. Rise, rose. Okay? Am, is, are. Means, for example, if am, obviously am, is, are the verbs, helping verbs which we use to present present tense. But right now, when you want to change from these verbs into past, you make it was or were, depends on the subject. Depends on the subject. Always remember. So, I hope you understood what are regular verbs and what are irregular verbs. Always remember, this is the basic rule for tenses as well, I would say, that for regular verbs, you can add ed to the root word, means what? Main verb only, okay? But for the irregular verb, we cannot add ed. Okay, it depends on the verb which it is. Please make sure that you are looking at the verb and then you are changing it. Just because it's a past tense, don't add ed. Just pay attention first whether it's a regular verb or whether it's irregular verb. So I hope you understood this, right? Let's move forward. Now, simple past tense is used to express the idea that an action started and finished at a specific time in the past. As I said, you completed with your playing. For example, you studied, you played, you worked, okay, you ate. So this all are what? Simple past tense. We use simple past tense to series of completed action in the past. Series matlab teen char cheeze humne saath mein ki hai past mein, to hum series bolenge, okay? The simple past tense can be used with a duration which starts and stops in the past. Wahan pe hi start hua hai, wahan pe hi khatam ho chuka hai. It can also be used to describe a habit which stopped in the past only. Means, for example, I used to drink coffee. I used to. So, meri habit thi wo, ab nahi hai. I have already stopped in the past only. Normally, the habit which you have stopped in the past only, then it's simple past tense. Okay, let's see more. Example, I studied Hindi when I was a child. Then it's a past habit. Now, aapne Hindi padhi jab aap bachche the. So that's what. He played the guitar. AD is desi. So it is simple past tense. They did not stay at the party the entire time. We talked on phone for 35 minutes. I finished work, walked to the beach, found a nice place to stay. Series of action. Matlab maine teen char kaam kiye. So it is what? Series of action. And if you see the words which are in yellow, they all are past tense verb. Okay? I saw a play yesterday. Again, past tense. Prachi ate an orange. So Prachi is a subject, ate is a verb, and orange is what? Object. So it's simple past tense. As ate is simple past tense verb. Now, simple form, simple past tense form, verb plus ed or d, that is known as second form of the verb, okay? If the verb is study, it will turn to studied. She studied for 2 hours. Write will turn to wrote. Now, if you see over here, we cannot say write it. There is one reason about it, why? Yes, because it's irregular verb. So, we will say wrote over here, okay? She wrote neatly in her notebook. Play. She played in the garden. So I hope you understood simple past tense as well. So let's go to the simple future tense. Now, simple future tense refers to time later than now and expresses a fact or certainty. Now, for example, what is future tense? Future matlab, see, we are talking about tomorrow. We are talking about tomorrow. For example, we say always with the main verb now, with the main verb. Before the main verb, you always use will. For example, I will go. So what is it? What does it mean that you have not gone? Ya aap ja nahi rahe ho, aap jaane wale ho. I will go. I will eat. Okay. I will play in the evening. I will meet her tomorrow. So this all says that you haven't done this action or you're not going to do it right now. It is what you will be doing in the future. When you will be doing will in the future, that time you say will or shall. We use will or shall. So for example, I shall visit her tomorrow. I shall eat my lunch by 2 p.m. I shall meet her tomorrow. Okay, this way. Use the simple future tense to talk about an action or condition that will begin and end in the future only. We use will or shall plus main verb in future tense. Shall is mainly used with I or we to make an offer or suggestion or ask for advice. I shall help you with your work later. So I is the subject, as I said, first person or third person. I shall. Okay. We shall go to the party tomorrow. Shall I open the window? Again, it is what? Simple future tense. Now, the future tense rule says that formula for simple future tense is what? Will plus root form of the verb. You can say shall as well, as I said you before. To make the simple future negative, the formula is will plus not plus root form. Okay. I will not go. Simple. Right. The subject is singular or plural. The formula of the simple future doesn't change. Now, always remember, always. Jo verb hota na, main verb, jaise hum present tense mein es ya s lagate hai, jaise hum kar rahe, okay? Past tense mein ed laga rahe hai. Future mein hum verb ko nahi change karenge. If verb is eat, you will write eat only. If verb is play, you will write play only. What you will add is before the verb, will or shall, depends on the subject. For example, verb hai eat. So, aap eat ka eat nahi karoge, ya eats nahi karoge. What you will say, will eat. Okay? Same way, will play. You will not change the base form of the verb. Always remember in future tense. To make the simple future negative, the formula is will plus not plus root form. Example, I will not study, they will not study. Prachi will eat an orange, will eat as I said you. So it is what? Simple future tense. Simple future tense, will or shall plus verb. Study, she will study for 2 hours. So if you see over here, study is the main verb. Before main verb, I'm using will. Yes. Write, she will write neatly in a notebook. Play, she will play in the garden. Okay, so I hope you all understood the simple form of tenses. And don't worry, I will be covering all 12 types of tenses very soon. So stay tuned. Till then, like, share, comment and subscribe. Okay, thank you everyone for watching my video. See you soon. Keep learning, keep watching. Bye-bye.